election-related news. The Election Commission has set up a panel of officers to examine Prime Minister Narendra Modi's address to the nation on Wednesday to examine whether it violated the Model Code of Conduct. The decision was taken after the commission held an internal consultation on Prime Minister's address, successfully testing an anti-satellite missile on Wednesday morning. According to senior officials, the panel will seek a transcript of the Prime Minister's speech from the government immediately and look into the urgency of the address to the nation. TMC Chief and West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee on Wednesday released her party's manifesto. She said the manifesto focuses on issues of national importance for the upcoming Lok Sabha elections. The manifesto promises a revival of the Planning Commission and 200 days work with double pay for MGNREGA workers. Mamata Banerjee said that her party will review the GST and will simplify it if voted to power. She also said that her party will discuss these issues with other political parties as well before finalizing on a common minimum program. Elections for the 42 Lok Sabha seats in West Bengal will be held in 7 phases. Meanwhile, Congress General Secretary Priyanka Gandhi Vadra campaigned in Amethi, the constituency of her brother and Congress President Rahul Gandhi. Interacting with the booth workers in Amethi, Priyanka said, "Amethi is like family and home to the Gandhi family." She told the party workers to reach out to the villages. She also said the Congress party fulfills its promises, pointing out that farm loans were waived soon after the Rajasthan government was formed. The Congress leader also said her party had promised to give 72,000 rupees yearly to poor families and will fulfill the promise if voted to power. Actor Urmila Matondkar on Wednesday joined the Congress party after meeting party president Rahul Gandhi at his residence. She joined the party in the presence of Maharashtra Congress chief Milind Deora and Sanjay Nirupam. Addressing a press conference after joining the party, Urmila said she believes in the ideology of the grand old party.
आज के दौर में जबकि केंद्र में ये पार्टी सत्ता में ना होने के बावजूद मैं पूरे जद्दोजहद से मैं पूरे अपने थिंकिंग मेरे पूरे जो आचार विचार सबके साथ अगर इस कांग्रेस पार्टी से जुड़ना चाहती हूँ मैंने मेरी ज़िंदगी में कोई चीज़ हाफ आटे ली नहीं की है ना मैं ये करना चाहूँगी क्योंकि जब आप लोगों के बीच उनकी सेवा करने का अंदेशा लेके जाते हो तो ये बहुत बड़ी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी होती है तो मैं कहीं जाने वाली हूँ नहीं मैं यहीं हूँ और बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया
And Bhojpuri singer and actor Dinesh Lal Yadav Nirahua joined the Bharatiya Janata Party on Wednesday. He joined the party in Lucknow in the presence of Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath. The actor said he will fight the elections if the party decides to field him.
हम जो है वो भारतीय जनता पार्टी के साथ हैं हम भी चाहते हैं कि देश में जो है फिर से नरेंद्र मोदी जी प्रधानमंत्री बने और इसलिए हम जुड़ रहे हैं और आगे जो भी आदेश होगा
बीजेपी एमपी अंशुल वर्मा जॉइन द समाजवादी पार्टी ऑन वेंसडे दिस आफ्टर ही वाज डिनाइड टिकट बाय द पार्टी फॉर द अपकमिंग लोकसभा इलेक्शंस ही जॉइन द समाजवादी पार्टी इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ अखिलेश यादव Tumkur, a semi-urban constituency barely 62 kilometers from Bengaluru, is shaping into a tough battle for the Congress-JDS alliance. It has also armed the BJP with ammunition to question the JDS that it is not being able to look beyond its first family. Here's a report from our correspondent Rajat Kane.
An intense battle is on the cards for the Tumkur Lok Sabha seat. JDS patriarch H.D. Devgowda is in the fray as the joint candidate of the Congress-JDS alliance. But all is not rosy for Gowda. The Congress had won the seat in 2014 and the party is not happy for giving the seat to the JDS.
Today, the Tumkur voters are supporting Mr. Devgowda and basically it is a JDS constituency. In last assembly segment election also, we have taken upper hand. 3 MLAs are belongs to the JDS, 1 MLA belongs to the Congress party, and the total vote sharing around 7 lakh votes polled in favor of JDS and Congress, around 4 lakh votes polled in favor of BJP. So the ground reality is very good. That is why we have decided to field Mr. Devagoda as a candidate.
The main rival, the BJP, is questioning the JDS on playing dynastic politics. Not only Devagoda, even two grandsons, Nikhil Gowda from Mandya and Prajwal Revanna from Hassan, are contesting the elections, which means the first family of the JDS is contesting 3 of the 7 seats it has been given.
Also, you said they are contesting 7 seats, but they had to give up on one seat, which is Bangalore North, because they could not find another candidate from within their family to contest the seat. So this only shows that there is lack of leadership in the party, and it is clearly very feudalistic in nature, equivalent to that of the Congress, where you cannot go beyond the Gandhi family when it comes to leadership. And the same can be seen in the case of JDS as well.
The battle in Tumkur is not just a straight contest between the Congress-JDS alliance and the BJP. The entry of Mudda Hanume Gowda, who is a sitting MP and now a Congress rebel, contesting as an independent, has opened up calculations. The Congress party is, however, sure that they'll convince the rebel to back the official candidate and also to take back his nomination.
Complicating the Tumkur battle is the entry of sitting MP and now Congress rebel Mudda Hanume Gowda. The Congress says it's confident of convincing him to step down in favor of the coalition candidate. The party is well aware that it needs to keep its house in order to pose any challenge to the BJP candidate, former MP G.S. Basava Raju.
Then again, 29th is the withdrawal date. So I am confident that I will persuade him to withdraw. And I will also persuade Mr. Rajanna, who is also applied it from our own party. If these two withdraw on 29th, I think we will have absolutely no problem. But in case, if both of them contest, then we will have a different political strategy. In spite of that, we will definitely win this seat.
For the JDS, winning the seat has become not only a matter of preserving cohesion with its coalition partner, but also ensuring the future of the next generation of the Gowda family. Rajat Kent's report for Rajya Sabha TV.